We are under the lights as the show gets you ready for another edition of Major League Baseball. Ought to be a good one here between the Philadelphia Phillies and the New York Mets. So coming to the plate, Gene Segura. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Two ball, one strike.
On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline in that. You get a count in your favor, he's swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
3-2 now. Now the payoff pitch home. Liner toward right center. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. In now, Andrew McCutchen. Line to the right side.
Conforto
is there, one away. Here's Bryce Harper now. He's ready for his first at bat of this early season contest.
Harper.
And that misses, 2-1. Sliced hard on the ground. And that's through for a hit. So now to the plate, Reese Hoskins. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Line drive to left. Cespedes is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now. So next to the plate for the Phils, JT Realmuto, lifetime numbers against Steven Matz, comes in with 6 hits in 22 tries. Swing and a miss on the sinker, and it's 1-2.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside, 3-2.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best.
He's able to take the ball the other way here. High and deep to right center. And that one is gone on a 2-strike count with 2 away in the inning. Into the box, Didi Gregorius. And they'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now.
Well, I think he just kind of lost focus on the mound right there. It's clearly not going his way, and he's thinking more about that than the task at hand. And right now he needs to think about this hitter.
And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. Now a sinker this time, but this ball stays outside as he loses him here. It's ball 4. Stepping in, Nick Williams. And he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
To me, it looks like he just doesn't trust himself out there on the mound. It's like he's fighting his body on every pitch, and as a result, we're seeing a lot of balls from him early on in this game.
This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with 2 away.
3-2, 2 out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Well, this won't get over the second baseman's glove as he's got it to end the inning. And that'll bring in the former top prospect, Amed Rosario. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-2. Misses for the second ball. Really starting to pour now, and the forecast is not showing any signs of a break in the weather.
Total agreement, Matt, in particular that pitcher's mound. You know, one of the things you have to really be careful, not just for the position players, but that mound gets awfully slippery and awfully wet when it becomes moist like it is right now. So the umpires are going to have to really pay attention to the conditions on the field.
The 2-1. Hit hard to short. There's Segura. Throw gets him. Two down. Jeff McNeil will be the next to take a turn. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. And they'll turn to the slider here, and it just misses. Two and one now. In there, two and two. Two out, nobody on. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Chasing after it is Williams. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. And in steps Scott Kingery. He had a homer in the ballgame yesterday afternoon.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. So the bases are empty with one man gone, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Vince Velasquez. Line to the right side, and the pitcher's got himself a base hit.
The batter, number two, shortstop.
Stepping in now, Gene Segura, and he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. The 2-2. Velasquez at second. Segura is over at first with one away. Changeup laid off down around the shins. Well, you don't need us to tell you it's really starting to come down out there. I can't imagine the umpires will let this go too much longer if it doesn't ease up.
Yeah, Matt, right now this doesn't look too good. I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see the umpires come out and bring the ground crew out here. The infield around the mound and around the home plate area is really getting soaked and wet. I can't anticipate this going on very much longer.
Harper.
Set. Here's the 3-1. Three and two now.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
And a sinker called strike three as he's rung up and the side is retired. Up next, the power bat of Pete Alonso. He'll lead it off against Vince Velasquez.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Line toward the gap in left center. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. Throw into second. But it won't be in time, and it's a leadoff double. To the plate now, Michael Conforto. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. Back goes Harper. Gone into the upper tank. Into the box now, Wilson Ramos. Grounded back up the middle. Segura fields it cleanly. And the throw here is in time. Very nicely done there at short for the first down. So one away here with the bases empty. And up next, the big RBI-minded bat of Yoenis Cespedes. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. McCutchen going back. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Here's Jake Marisnik to try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and it's full 3-2.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, Those are the ones.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Stepping up now, Rhys Hoskins. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. So a leadoff single will be the start to their half of the third. At the plate now, JT Realmuto. Swing and a line drive. Foul. Two balls and two strikes to the Phillies catcher.
You can really tell about how effective this guy's going to be when guys are swinging at that changeup. So far in this one, they've been real smart to let it go.
Oh, and he botches it. Digging in now for Philadelphia, Didi Gregorius. He drew a base on balls his first time up. The 3-1 pitch hit hard down the line. On the ground to second base, this could be two. One there, on to first, a double play. Now at the plate, Nick Williams. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
Here's the 2-1. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1. Hit on the ground out to short. Rosario's got it. Throw on to first, and that error won't come back to haunt him after all as the inning is over. So here now is the pitcher, Steven Matz, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. Now the 1-1 pitch is swung on and missed for strike number two. Skied into straightaway right. Harper is there and he makes the catch for the out. So one man gone for the Mets in the third, and up next will be the shortstop, Amed Rosario. 1-1 home. Is looked at for ball number two. Third inning. Already a 3-2 ball game. Line drive to center field. But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out.
The third baseman.
Next for the Mets, J.D. Davis. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Two outs, nobody on, but a base runner here feels like it would really change the complexion of the inning.
Big spot right here. Middle of the order guy is coming up. Let's see if he can extend the inning.
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 3-2 one more time. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner. Now the 3-2 pick. It's the top of the zone. He struck him out looking. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Scott Kingery comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. A 1-1 is in there for the second strike. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Rosario's got it cleanly. Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth. So the base is empty here with one away, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Vince Velasquez. The 1-1. sent on the ground out to second.
He's got it.
And there's out number two. Gene Segura standing in. It was a walk in his last trip.
Gene Segura.
The 3-1.
Line toward the gap in left center. That gets down and the inning continues.
Now batting. Left fielder.
In now, Andrew McCutcheon. Line drive to left. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Next up from New York, Pete Alonso. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at-bat.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at-bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Pete Alonso sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning. And it's two balls and two strikes now. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. Out of here, into the visitor's bullpen. Into the box, Wilson Ramos. Down low, two balls and a strike. Three runs, three hits, one error in the game for the Mets thus far. 2-2 to the Mets catcher.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel of that one.
And he chased one there as this is bounced to short. Segura has it. In time to first, and there are two away. So bases are empty here with two gone. And up next, the big RBI-minded bat of Yoenis Cespedes. The 1-1 is taken for ball two. Three and one to the Mets left fielder. There's a fastball on the inner third taken for a strike. Staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. The next 3-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Paul Sewald is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. New inning set to get underway. Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at-bat.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Oh, and they pulled a string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring in a perennial MVP candidate for years to come, Rhys Hoskins. Fouled away. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. Lifted down the line and left. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Three runs, six hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. And a great inning here as he gets another punch out and strikes out the side in order. Stepping in, Jake Marisnik. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
High and deep down the left field line. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. Now a foul tip right into the catcher's glove as he's able to hang on for the first out. Robinson Cano will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes.
You could bet he wants that one back at the plate right now. That's a pitch you normally see a guy drive if he has the right approach going.
Struck him out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And up next will be the shortstop, Amed Rosario. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Hit in the air down the right field line. And foul. And he struck him out. His eighth punch out of the ballgame. And that one ends the inning. Justin Wilson will come on in relief as he'll make his second appearance of the season so far.
Number 38.
At the plate, Didi Gregorius, 0-1 for him here in this one. And it's fouled away. The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
The fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. Up next will be Nick Williams. He started out the evening 0-2 so far. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. Fouled off. Bases are empty here with two men out. Popped up. Davis will put this one away and the side is retired. Robert Stock enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 89.
J.D. Davis the next to bat. It was a walk in his last trip. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The next 1-2 pitch. Hard hit ball to second. Gregorius is there. And a good throw gets him one gone. One away now for the Mets in the sixth. And that'll bring in Jeff McNeil. Now the 1-1 pitch is laid off for ball two. Bases are empty, one man out. Line toward the gap in left center. But this will hang up just enough as he takes it in stride in left center for the second out. So here's Pete Alonso. He went down on strikes last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Left side of the infield into the shift. Throw in time and the side is retired. Brad Brock is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 29.
Davy Grillon is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number 7. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1.
Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball. 2-2.
I can't imagine he was sitting on fastball at his neck right there. He is going to have to lower his sights if he's going to have any chance.
Breaks is bad as this one's popped up, and he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first down.
Now batting.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Gene Segura. He steps in off a base hit in his last at bat. 1-1. Misses, ball two. Phillies shortstop in front of the count, 3-1.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Takes this the other way to right. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. Stepping in now, Andrew McCutchen. On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now. And this pitch is foul tip right into the glove of Ramos as he stays with it to record the strikeout. So stepping in, Bryce Harper. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Here's one that misses now to the Philly right fielder. It's two balls and a strike. Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it. This is line to left. And that'll get down for a base hit. And that's going to move that go-ahead run to second now with two gone. Standing in now, Reese Hoskins. And here's a slider for a called strike, and he's behind 1-2 now. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Sir Anthony Dominguez will come on out of the bullpen as he'll be appearing in his third game this season.
Number 58.
Now at the plate, Michael Conforto, already 2-for-2. He'll look to add on right here.
This guy's having a pretty good week so far in one game. His last at-bat, his second home run of the game. We'll see if they'll pitch him a little bit more carefully in this AB.
McCutchen is under it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. One out, nobody on. Here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. And they'll back him off a bit with a fastball in, but it's 3-1 now. Waiting his turn on deck, Yoenis Cespedes. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Now a swing and a fly ball. On the move is Harper, but this will land untouched. Lays off, ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Digging in, Yoenis Cespedes, 0-for-2 for him to this point.
You know, Madden, every team has that one guy, and Yoenis Cespedes is that guy for the Mets. Completely changes that complexion for that Mets betting order.
Cespedes behind a ball and two strikes. Ready on 1-2. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
Up next to the bat.
Now at the plate, Jake Marisnik. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Counts even a 2-2 to Marisnik. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Two-two pitch is fouled away. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. Jerry's Familia will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Brandon Nimmo will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch.
Number nine, Brandon Nimmo.
Now the payoff pitch home, lifted in the air out to right. Right fielder is on the run. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Coming to the plate now, Didi Gregorius. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. The 1-1 home takes a pitch for strike number two. Bases are empty, one man out. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. And another foul ball. Here's another 1-2.
You know, something to keep in mind, they're really burning through that bullpen, and this is only the first game of the series. Definitely could have an impact on the rest of the series and maybe even the whole week ahead.
The 2-2 one more time. Hit down the line at first. Scooped up, and he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. Digging in, Nick Williams. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. Ready with the 1-1. Back up the middle. Oh, look at the sliding stop. He gathers the throw. It's there, and he's out. Victor Arano will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Adam Haseley is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
Batting nine. Number 40, Adam.
And the 3-1. Now Nimmo connects out to deep right field. And as Mets fans have heard before, that ball's out of here. At the plate, Amed Rosario. Two balls and a strike to Amed Rosario. With this one almost in books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
In now, J.D. Davis. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
3-1 to him now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes.
I got 3-2.
Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. He'll throw down to first, one away. Ready once again, Jeff McNeil. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. The 2-1 home. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 2-2 gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout. So striding in, Pete Alonso, runner in scoring position with two gone.
Alonso.
Payoff pitch on its way. Skied into straightaway right. Harper giving chase. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Seth Lugo takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door.
Number 67.
All set to start the ninth in this one. Standing in, Scott Kingery, who could really use a knock here, 0-3 in the game so far. Here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. Swing and a liner. And that'll make him 1-for-4 in this one. So the tying run is aboard here in the ninth.
Now batting, the center fielder, Adam Hazley.
To the plate now, Adam Hazley. Oh, had a hanger that time, but missed it. 1-2. Hard hit ball to second. Fielded cleanly to second for one. On to first, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game, as there are quickly two away now. Phillies down to their final out now. And that'll bring in Gene Segura. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. 2-1. One run game here in the top of the ninth. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now. And this will be a called strike two, and trouble now as they're down to their final strike tonight. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game. Time called here, as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen. They'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. And he'll dive back in. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. After it is Cespedes. And he tracks it down, and this ball game is over.
Hey, we were really treated to a good one today. Bottom of the eighth proved to be the difference, though, and a good job here in the ninth to close the book on this one.
And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball game. The New York Mets came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Jerry Familia claims the win out of the pen, his first. Seth Lugo closes the door for the save, his second. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
The final run score for our ball game tonight, for the victorious New York Mets. 4 runs on 5 hits, 1 error. They left 3 men on base. For Philadelphia, 3 runs on 9 hits, no error. They left 8 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 4 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.